Do any of you guys know Ron Sullivan or Al Duncan in the house? Everyone know? Make some noise for Ron Sullivan and Al Duncan. Okay. Well, they're about to come up to the stage, talk about what they do, give you guys a little bit of advice. And the cool thing is they're going to have a workshop later on after lunch. So make sure you hit their workshop up. Really cool guys. They're going to come up here and spark it up. So, yes, I said spark it up. Mm-hmm. I did say it up. What do you want me to say? Spark it up. See, thank you. Mm-hmm. Me and her are going to be the only people like, let's spark this up. We're going to look at you. Are you ready to go? Are you ready to go? Spark this up. All right. Let's make some noise. Let's give it a big round of applause for Ron Sullivan and Al Duncan, everybody. Al from Monster. Make some noise.
1, 2.
Y4, let's make some noise in here. Let's go, let's go. Uh-huh. Get up, get up.
I know what it
up,
is. Don't act like y'all don't know. Let's show us some love. What's up, Y4?
We never went nowhere, but they say it run it back. Blame it on that contour, we call it Monster Yak.
And I'm on this foolish track, so I spit my foolish flow.
Look at my crew over here.
Y'all know what this is, right? What's that? That's a triple sword. Boom!
Last time on a college remix, now I'm on the original version. Can't never count me out.
Y'all better count me in.
Got 20 bank accounts.
Accountants count me in.
Make millions every year. The South champion.
Cause all we do, all we do
is win, no matter what. Got money on my mind, I can never get enough.
And every time we step inside the building, everybody's hands go up. Bro, time.
And they stay there, and they say yeah.
What?
And they stay there. Up, down. Cause all I do is win.
We win.
If you go in, put your hands in the air.
Make them stay there.
I love it.
What's going on,
Y4? Make some noise.
Yeah.
When I say why, you say four. Why? Why? When I say I'm a, you say leader. I'm a. When I say I'm gone, you say get it. I'm gone.
Get it?
Are they wrong?
You know what?
What?
Y'all having a good time?
They're having a good time.
Y'all let me see. Y'all having a good time?
They having a good time.
If you enjoying Y4, make some noise.
Woo!
Well, you know what? You know, we came early. There's a big party going on in here. And a big reason for that was this man right here, DJ Kid J. DJ Kid J. Let them know how you get down, sir. Show him some, Kid J.
Show him some. Oh, let's see this. What you got?
Yeah. Go DJ. Oh, he licked the fingers. It's about to be on
he's
now.
Doing well, right?
Yeah. Warm it up. Yeah, y'all make it up for DJ Kid J.
I love that ride. Hold on, man. We've been coming back and forth all month. Now, I'm gonna pull out this paper.
We gotta
make sure.
We like to get things right.
We got to get things right.
Let's make sure that everybody who's in here is supposed to be here.
My paper we got tore up and everything.
We can fix it.
Y'all know I'm real. Look at this piece of paper right here.
Yeah, we keeping it real right now.
All right, hold on. Apple Valley High School, where y'all at?
Okay, they made it.
Who
they must got here.
Who we got there?
Where's Career Institute?
Career Institute
represent. Career Institute. All over the place. All right.
What does that say? Hold up. We're going to get ashy, man.
Unfold it. We got to bring her out here. She ripped our paper.
Chino, where y'all at?
We are programmed.
We love it. Cry Rob.
You know what? Family Service Association.
Where y'all
FSA,
at?
Where you at? Where we at? All right, let me hear you.
Mojave High School, yeah.
All right, we got NCNW, where you at?
Bethune, where y'all at? Bethune.
Okay,
that's
all right.
You rep yourself, baby. That's all right.
We don't need numbers.
What is that? That's KFC?
That ain't KFC.
Oh, that's a NCFC.
NCFC, where y'all at? NCFC.
My bad. Operation New Hope.
Al Duncan said that one.
And you know we gotta show much love to the Pal Center.
Where's the Pal Center at?
Yeah, we love it, we love it. So Ron, we got some things to talk to him about today.
We find something to talk about.
Four words we gotta talk to him about.
Listen, everybody who's been up here, we've had phenomenal speakers. Give it up for all our speakers who came before you. They're doing a great job. But here's one thing that I'm very, very impressed about. Ever since we've been a part of this program and coming to do the workshops at your individual sites and even coming here today, we are so impressed to see people who are interested and eager to learn how to be successful. That's right. Give yourselves a round or make some noise for yourselves. That's a wonderful thing because everybody's not trying to do better. In fact, a lot of you have people in your lives right now that don't want to see you do better because if you don't go anywhere, it makes it okay for them to stay where they're at. But if you are determined to get where you're supposed to in life, let me hear you say, yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I want to hear.
Yeah.
So all the speakers have been giving you information on how to get where you want, motivation, inspiration, we want a little perspiration, whatever it takes to get there. That's right, degree.
You better check yourself.
So what Al and I are going to do is we're going to try and simplify this thing down to four important words. And if you can stick with these words, it's going to help you in putting your plan and help make your journey a little bit earlier.
Right.
So I'm going to say a word. Just so I know that you're with me, I want you to repeat the word after I say it. Let me hear you say connect. Learn. Inspire.
Inspire.
And lead.
Lead.
One more time. Connect.
Connect.
Learn.
Learn.
Inspire.
Inspire.
And lead.
Lead.
Al, talk about connect for a minute.
Raise your hands if you have a cell phone. Who has a cell phone? Okay, all the hands go flying up. Here's a question for you. How many of y'all can get on the internet on your cell phone? Okay. You got some internet. I need to take you on the road.
She real glad to be here.
Right. So you got a cell phone. You can get on the internet. It means your cell phone is a powerful device. It's a powerful device right in the palm of your hand. Got a question for you. What happens at night if you don't plug your cell phone in? It dies. So all of a sudden, you have this powerful little tool that ain't worth nothing. It's a powerful tool, but it's worth nothing now. You know why? Because you didn't plug it in. It don't have any juice. It has no power. It works the same way for each and every one of you all sitting here today. Every one of you in here is powerful beyond belief. More powerful than anything that could ever be created by man. But if you don't connect, if you don't plug yourself into something that can recharge and re-energize you, if you don't connect with people who think like you and want to achieve similar things that you want to accomplish in life, when you don't do that, what happens is you rob yourself of a vital resource and a vital source of energy that you need, and you all of a sudden become a lot less powerful than you could be. The first word we give you all is connect for a reason. Nobody succeeds all on their own. We've been talking to you all for a few months now about networking and connecting and putting your skills together. You gotta connect with people, you gotta stay connected, because sooner or later you go home the day and the real world kicks into place. And the only way you can keep recharging and re-energizing yourself is if you actually stay connected. Complete this phrase for me. It's not what you know, it's? That's true, but more importantly is who knows you. Now, Ron and I were talking about this before we came up here today. We said, you know what? The real test as to whether or not we were able to really help you all out or really help you to learn some things, the real test to whether or not we really connected you is when we saw you all out in the lobby and when we walked up here on stage, if you actually remembered who we are. That's the important thing, because that's when a real connection is established. Now, I'm talking about connection on a professional level right now, because I saw some of y'all earlier today. Y'all was like, ooh, I want to connect with her. Right. I know, I saw y'all, it's okay. But that's not what I'm talking about. We're talking about connecting on a professional level so that you can augment your career and do some of the things you want to accomplish. Everybody say connect.
Next word we're gonna talk about is learn. Now, I want your honest answer right now. How many of you attended workshops because you had to? Raise your hands. You came because you had to. I appreciate your honesty, I'm not mad at you. Most of the classes I took in school were not classes I wanted to attend.
In fact, the worst thing they ever did for me in college was tell me how many classes I could miss before I automatically failed. See, I listen a little differently than everybody else. The first day of class, they would hand out our syllabus telling us all our requirements for the semester. And they told me when I was in college, if you miss 10 classes, you have automatically failed this class. What my mind heard was, you are allowed to miss 9 classes.
Right.
So while everybody else was looking at when the papers were due, I was looking at which classes I was going to the beach. And I never missed an appointment at the beach. I was connecting.
I know you were.
But I wasn't learning. Now, the reason I say that is because sometimes we're put into an environment where learning is forced upon us. But truth be told, how many of you came to those sessions because you had to, but you learned something and you were glad you were there when you left? Mm-hmm. See, that's what being a learner is. What we always say is, I don't care why you're in the building, I'm just glad you're in the building. Because just being there means something we say has the opportunity to impact you in some way, shape, or form. Here's the truth. You saw in the video that Road Trip showed, you saw some successful people. Damon Dash from Harlem, where I live. Very successful individual. But what he said in something in there that was very profound. Everything he did, he knew nothing about it before he did it. That means that when he went into music, he had to learn the music business. When he went into fashion, he had to learn the fashion business. When he decided to be a boxing promoter, he had to learn the boxing game, how to make movies. He could not have accomplished anything he spoke about in that video, and he could not be on his pathway to being a billionaire, which is his dream, unless he was committed to learning. Everybody in here has a dream. Everybody in here has a picture that you would like, a snapshot you would like your life to look like one day. You cannot get there if you do not learn what it takes to be there. It's great to have a vision of something, but you need to know what it takes. And here's the real secret of success. You never stop learning. Never stop learning. Mm-hmm. How many of you think that, anybody have the new iPad? iPad 3, the new iPad. How many of you think that's the last iPad that's coming out? There'll probably be one by the time I finish speaking, right? You know why? Because Apple understands if we want to stay in business, we've got to keep going. We've got to see what worked on this one. How can we make it better? We got to keep learning. So if people who already have billions of dollars are committed to learning every day, what do you think we ought to be doing? Keep learning. Not just learn, keep learning. You should learn something new every single day. A new word, a new phrase, a new pathway, a new model, anything. When I got here last night, I flew in from New York yesterday. I called Al, ran over to his hotel room. He had already, by the time I left his hotel room, he gave me 2 new concepts, emailed me 2 new books I need to go home and read right now because I'm committed to always learning. And you got to have people in your lives. Once you've connected with them, find people who can teach you something.
That's right.
There's a law, if you want to call it that, the law of five. What that means is you will always become the average of your 5 closest connections. Mm. Now think about the 5 people you are the closest to. At least 2 of those people in that group should be teaching you something. You should never be the smartest person you know.
Hey, I'll tell you, Ron, when I first heard that, I was kicking people out of my house.
That's why, yo, love you, gotta right. Go. You should not be the smartest person you know. Because if you're the smartest person you know, who do you learn from? How do you get better? So you should always have at least 2 people in your lives that you're learning from. You should also have a couple of people in your life that you're helping learn from you. Information, if it comes to you, means nothing if you don't turn around and pass it on to somebody else. That's what we're doing. We have information. We're here to share it with you. If it leaves with us, then it's meaningless. So the commitment that everyone needs to make to get where you want to go is to keep your mind open to always learning. I don't care if I don't want to be here for an hour. I don't care if this workshop doesn't look interesting. I need information. And if you're in the front of the room, there's a good chance you have something I can get. And my goal in this hour, in this time, in your workshop, is to get whatever it is you have to offer me because I readily admit I don't know it all. So if you want to be successful, who wants to be successful? Now, you know what? I'm sorry. I asked the wrong question.
Uh-oh.
Who wants to be really successful? You cannot get there unless you are willing to commit right here, right now, to being a lifelong learner. Can you do that for me? If you're going to learn something before you leave, why for today? Say, yeah. All right. So our second word was learn. Al D.
So those of you all who heard me tell my story before, you all know my story. From the hood to all good. Teenage parents, mom was 15, dad was 18, jacked up neighborhood, no money, messed up grades, counselor who was hating on me, found out that my father, the preacher, and my grandmother's church was addicted to crack cocaine. Messed up, right? None of that matters, though. If I wanted to be successful, whose choice was it? Still on me. I made it past all that, make it to college, become a professional saxophone player. I walked away from my musical career at the height of it to go raise my youngest brother. I was playing the saxophone, but I took my saxophone. What did I do with it? I sold it. I sold it to go home and take care of my younger brother. When I got back home, it was just like my mom said it was. I had to go to war with guys in the neighborhood of my little brother. I got people pointing shotguns in my face, people pointing 9mm handguns in my face. I got to rumble and scrap with people 3 and 4 o'clock in the morning over my little brother. Here's the point. At that point in my life, I was a knucklehead. So was he. What we were missing, both of us, was inspiration. I didn't aspire to be anything because I wasn't inspired to be anything. Now, some people get confused with that word inspire. They think it means you got to be rah, rah, motivated and all over the place, this, that, and other. Does it mean that? No, doesn't mean that. I'm going to tell you what inspired means, where it first came from, what the meaning first meant, what it meant from the very beginning. It means to breathe new life into something. That's what it means. Sometimes that's all you need. Did you just blow in that mic? I got sound effects going on.
That was new life.
Right. Sometimes that's all it is. You just need a breath of fresh air. Now, here's the thing. While you're searching for inspiration, the cool thing for me is that I know a whole lot of you all sitting here. It's only a few of you all that I didn't get a chance to meet. I know most of you all sitting here. I know the youth advisors that are in here. I know the people that's running the programs. I've met most of you all. And I'm going to tell all of y'all young people that's sitting here something about inspiration. Now, sometimes when you're looking at somebody and you're getting some inspiration, actually inspiration is a two-way street. It is. Because you can go ask anybody that's working with you, anybody that's been helping you, you can ask me. And you say, do you think you inspired? And we might say, yeah. But the real thing is that, no, you inspire us. Y'all feel what I'm saying? And I mean that from the bottom of my heart. When you try to become an inspiration to somebody else, you get inspiration yourself, and it can be the driving force behind what you want to accomplish and what you want to do. People look at me and they say, man, your whole life changed. You went home to get your little brother, you raised him, now you're a successful business, own three businesses, written 4 books, traveled all around the world, spoken to over 1 million students. Man, that's awesome. You saved your little brother's life. And you know what? I stopped him right in their tracks. That's not how it worked. Actually, he saved my life. Because if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be doing any of the things that I'm doing right now today. Continue to look for inspiration, but understand that every last one of you all sitting here, you got a story. You got a story. Just like everybody else who got up on this stage, you got a story. And your story is an inspiration to somebody. And when you go back to your neighborhoods today, continue to step out there and be an inspiration to the people that are around you, because you can help lift them up as well. You got to be an inspiration, and you got to search for inspiration. Everybody say inspire.
Last word we want to share with you is a very important word. If you are a leader, raise your hands. If you believe you are a leader, raise your hands. Keep your hands up. Keep your hands up. Because I love to meet new leaders. Now, I want you to answer a very important question for yourself. Answer it silently. You can put your hands down. You know if you had it up a minute ago. If you are a leader, what I want you to ask yourself is, who are you leading and where are you taking them? If you claim to be a leader, I'm not questioning your leadership, but if you are a leader, my question to you is, who exactly are you leading and where exactly are you taking them? Here's what leadership is in the most simple definition I've ever heard. Leadership is influence. Nothing more, nothing less. If you are influencing anybody around you, you are a leader. Everybody in here is being led by someone. Now, who are your influences? Who do you follow? Who gets you to do what they want you to do? Companies are great at that, aren't they? Companies are real good influences. Yes, here's how good some companies are. Anybody here, if I say the phrase, just do it, who am I talking about? Nike. See, they got a lot of influence, right?
Uh-huh.
Now, Nike has so much influence, they can take something they made, say, I don't know, 30 years ago.
And bring it back.
Put retro on the box.
Right.
Raise the price $40 and sell it like it's brand new. They can take some stuff that's left over in the warehouse from the 80s and sell it now like it's new. And we will line up like, I got to have them. Why? Because they said so. That's influence. Who's influencing us today? We don't want you to settle for being influenced. We want you to now become influencers. We want you to be leaders, but we want you to be strategic leaders. Think about, who am I leading? Who's around me? Who am I having an impact on? Is it my friends? I'm sure all of you in here have friends that are not in this program, that are waiting for you to get out so we can go do whatever we're gonna do later. Right. But are you taking what you're getting here and go sharing that with your friends? Family members, younger siblings who are looking up to you. And you heard some of the other speakers say, part of success, a big part of it, is working hard, setting a good example, having a set of values that you subscribe to, following your passion. All of those things are great. But if you're doing everything that you're doing in and of and about yourself, then it's meaningless. Because each and every one of us belongs to a larger community, a larger network. Shoot, Y4 is a family all by itself.
Yes, indeed.
That's why we have so much fun, because when you get with family, you can have a good time. Hey, when you get with family, you can say stuff you don't say in public.
Uh-oh.
Y'all think I run around and jump like this at home? Shoot, Harlem, that'll get you jumped. But this is family, so I can come and have a good time when I'm here at the Y4 event. But the most important thing about leadership, is the level of accountability you're willing to take. I know people are watching me. So what am I showing them? I know I have the opportunity and the ability to impact others. So what am I showing them? How many people want to go to college or in college? Okay, now keep your hand up. If you're the first person, or you have the opportunity to be the first person you know to graduate from college. If you're going to be the first person. If you're going to be the first person, when you finish college, you're going to be the first person you know, family member or friend. So you know what you all are? You're leaders. Because there are people who are watching you right now. They're watching your work ethic. They're watching your commitment. They're watching your struggle. But what they see is that you're not giving up. What they see is you are so committed to reaching your goal. What it's telling them is, if you can do it, I can do it too.
That's right.
90%. Give yourselves a round of applause. That's a wonderful thing. 90% of all people are followers. They'll do whatever you tell them to do. Everybody, throw your hands in there. Everybody, hands up. See?
Works every time, don't it?
I have no purpose at all. I just said hands up. Y'all threw them up. I appreciate the cooperation. Don't get me wrong. I was trying to hype you up. You right.
You so crazy.
I am. That's why they shouldn't give me a microphone.
I know.
But the point I'm trying to make is, A, be careful who you follow. If you're following somebody, somebody's influencing you, where are they taking me? Why am I doing this? Why am I going in this direction? Why am I participating in this program? Why am I making these choices? Who's influencing me?
Right.
But then more importantly, make yourself a leader. Make yourself accountable. You know what? I'm going to make myself better so the people around me get better.
Right.
Remember I told you you're going to be the average of the five people you're closest to? I want everybody in here to raise your own average. Raise the average of your five. Make yourself better so everybody around you gets better. I'm going to read this book, and then I'm going to take the information, I'm going to share it with my friends. That's what Al does for me all the time. He gets a book, Ron, you got to read this book, new author, new information, because he's trying to help me get better. And I take that information and I pass it on. So as you all grow in Y4, through Y4, and beyond Y4, we want you to be leaders, not just in here, not just in San Bernardino. You guys are the next group of leaders for this entire country. Some of you are going to be on this stage continuing Y4 in the year 2026.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah. You getting a microphone before we're done. Not today. You going to make it bigger? All right, we got a leader over here. Says, let me take the program to the next level. That's what I'm talking about.
I love it.
That's what we're talking about. That's leadership. The world's waiting for you. 90% of the people out there saying, somebody please tell us what to do. What should I wear this year? What phrase should I use? What song should I listen to? What dance am I going to do? Am I going to Dougie? Am I going to beef it up? What am I going to do next? Somebody tell me something.
Please.
They're waiting for you. Because you guys are in this program, you're getting information, you're committing yourselves to being better, to growing, and you're ready to take the reins and lead. Are you ready to be a leader? I got like three leaders.
Uh-oh.
Are you ready to be a leader? Are you committed to being a leader? I think they might be ready.
They might be ready, man.
So first we gotta connect.
Connect.
Then we gotta
learn.
And then we need to
inspire.
And lastly, we're gonna
lead.
Wow, they got all four words.
They got them. Let me tell y'all a little story.
Uh-oh. He gonna tell them a story.
Once upon a time, there was an eagle egg. What kind of egg was it?
An eagle egg.
Eagle, like a bird. You got
what? What's the other kind of eagle?
I don't know. Like a Jeep or something? Okay. I'm talking about an eagle egg.
An eagle like an Eggo waffle? What's the
eagle? There's an eagle egg. Some kind of way, this eagle egg falls out of the nest, rolls down the side of a mountain. Amazingly enough, the eagle egg doesn't break, but it ends up on a farm. Ends up in a coop with all these chickens. The egg finally hatches. Eagle is born. And the hens and all the chickens in the coop decide, well, you here, you can hang out with us. We'll take care of you. So this eagle is raised by a group of chickens. Eagle walking around clucking like a chicken. Right? But it's an eagle, so you know he was all awkward. Right. Trying to figure out how come he can't fit in the hen house with everybody else. He's an eagle. Feeling like he don't belong. Eagle even thought he was ugly. Why? Because nobody looks like me. Nobody's thinking like me. What's going on here? But the eagle never realized. He figured he was a chicken.
He know no better.
One day, another eagle was flying over the farm. In case you don't know, eagles have sharp vision, sharpest vision in the animal kingdom. This eagle looks down from way up and looks down and sees the craziest thing he has ever seen in his life. He sees another eagle down there hanging out with chickens, cluck clucking. Eagle is like, what in the world is going on? The eagle flies down there. Listen to how the eagle says, yo, man, what are you doing? See what you mean? I'm doing, man. I'm eating my bird feed over here. Well, why are you doing that, man? You're supposed to be up there. What are you talking about? He said, man, you're an eagle, not a chicken. Eagle looked down at itself for a minute. He said, yeah, you know, I've always felt a little strange, like I was supposed to have something more in life. Did. I always felt like I was supposed to do a little bit more, but you know, I got all these chickens around me. They clucking, so I'm clucking. Other eagle says, look, man, let me show you. Spread your wings like this. Other eagle finally, for the first time in his life, spread his wings completely. He said, wow, man, that feels good. And he said, look, I'm going to show you something. He said, watch, man. Flap a couple times. Watch what happens. And he started flapping. He started coming up off the ground. He said, I didn't even know I could do this. The next thing you know, this eagle that had been hanging around with the chickens, cluck clucking all this time,
okay,
found out something very important. Found out that he was more than he ever knew he could be. Way more than he ever knew he could be. Let me tell y'all something. Some of y'all been hanging around chickens. But one thing I know, this is why for. Ain't no chickens in here.
That's right.
Y'all some eagles. If you an eagle, stand on your feet. If you an eagle and you know it, stand on your feet. Because I'm going to tell you right now. Now, if you got some, if you had some haters in your life, say cluck, cluck.
Time to go.
Right. If you ever tried to do something and it didn't turn out right, say cluck, cluck. Right. If you ever had some people trying to tell you you couldn't do what you wanted to do, say cluck, cluck. Right. Don't none of that matter. When you see them people, when them haters and doubters start creeping all about you, when you're going through your aches and pains, when you're going through your backs and forths and you struggling and you having a hard time, don't none of that matter. You know why? Because cluck, cluck ain't your theme song. You ain't no chicken. You're an eagle. Look at somebody sitting next to you. Give them a high five and say, it's time to fly, baby. It's time to fly.
Why four? Let's do it big. We're out.